Hello friends, namaskar. In our discussion on direct taxes, that is income tax, today's topic is it mandatory for NRI to file ITR in India? Why? Because lot of your NRI friends must be finding out an answer to this question, that when they have investment income in India, when they have any other income in India, is it mandatory for them to file ITR in India or not? So let's see what is the answer to this question. So friends, at first, I just put up before you the coverage of today's video having questions like who is an NRI, scope of income of NRI, income of NRI taxable in India, how to compute the total income of NRI in India, and when NRI is mandatorily required to file ITR in India. So let's proceed to see the answer to all these questions. So first of all, I put up the question, who is an NRI? Yet you must be knowing its definition, but let me start through a definition only. NRI means an individual being citizen of India or a person of Indian origin who is not a resident. Here the residential status means the residential status as determined under Section 6 of Income Tax Act 1961. Assuming that you are not a resident as per Section 6 of Income Tax Act 1961 of India, then in that case, if you are an individual and you have been pursuing business outside India, or you are working as a salaried paid outside India, or you are a person of Indian origin, then in that case you will be treated to be NRI in India. Now let me bring before you what is the scope of income of NRI in India. That is, which kind of income of NRI is taxable in India. Following income of NRI shall be taxable in India, and I would like to put here four type of income. Income accrue or arise in India. Income deemed to accrue or arise in India, like the income which are mentioned in Section 9 of Income Tax Act 1961, they are treated to be taxable in India. Income received in India, which you have directly received in India, or income which is deemed to be received in India. So this is a broad category, my dear friend. Even if you are NRI and you are primarily assuming that I don't have any taxation to attract in India, but if your income of whatever category, if it falls into any of these four points, then it becomes taxable in India. The same point which I discussed in terms of four categories, I am now putting it up in terms of headwise bifurcation of the income. The income of NRI taxable in India, my dear friend, could be in form of salary income. It could be in form of rental income, that is income from house property, or it may be income from business profession, or it may be like capital gain from sale of securities, real estate, or it could be in the form of other source income, say interest, dividend, etc. All such income of NRI would be taxable in India if it falls into either being accrued or arise in India, deemed to accrue or arise in India, received in India, or it is deemed to be received in India. Now let me put up before you the steps for computing the total income of NRI in India. And these steps, my dear friend, could be one, computing income under respective heads of income. Like you may have salary income, house property income, business income, capital gain income, other source income. That headwise income will be first computed. Then an aggregation of same shall be done to derive a figure which is called GTI, gross total income. From this amount of GTI, you will be entitled to avail certain deductions as per Chapter 6 of Income Tax Act, like Section 80C, etc. And the balance amount after reducing from GTI, these Chapter 6 deduction, will be treated to be total income of a NRI, which is basically taxable in India. Now I come to the principal question of today's video, which says when NRI is mandatorily required to file ITR in India. A very important point. In case, now here I am putting up my opinion. In case the gross total income for the relevant financial year of a NRI exceeds basic exemption limit. Say for example, for the financial year 2021 or 21-22, the basic exemption limit is 2.5 lakh. So moment your gross total income, point to be noted, my dear friend, here the gross total income, if it exceeds 2.5 lakh, primarily you are required to file ITR in India. Further, as an NRI, suppose you are availing capital gain exemption under Section 54 to 54F of Income Tax Act 1961. Say for example, you have sold a real estate. There is some long-term capital gain of 1.5 crore. You are reinvesting it into another property in India. So because of reinvestment, the ultimate capital gain income will become nil. But still, it is mandatory for you to file ITR in India. Now, when it is advisable for an NRI, in my opinion, here I am just adding my opinion, it is advisable to file ITR for NRI where NRI has made investment in India, or such a person, he or she, has deduction of tax at source in India. Yet these are not mandatory points, but I keep on suggesting to my NRI client, sir, if you have made investments in India and if you have any TDS deducted on you, it is better, it is advisable to file the return. I would repeat, sir, it is not mandatory. Why? Now, your question naturally to me would be, why, Mr. Bhatia, you are suggesting so? My suggestion of this particular nature is so because my professional experience is that those who regularly file their return are relaxed of income tax notices, are relaxed of income tax compliances as compared to those who are not filing their return of income. So this is just simply an advice from my side. You may or you may not follow the same. Now, I would like to further put up a specific exemption from ITR filing to an NRI given under two specific sections of income tax law. The first one, my dear friends, is section 115G, which says that where NRI has a specified investment income in India, like income from dividend, debenture interest, deposit interest, which is taxable under section 115E of the Income Tax Act at special rate, and assuming that TDS thereon is duly applied, then law says in such a case, NRI is not required to file return of income at all in India. Further, under section 115A, certain specific income like income from infrastructure debt fund, income from units of a business trust, income from investment fund, income from securitization trust, or income by way of interest from a Indian company, etc., like 194LB, LBA, 194LBB, 194LBC, 194LC. These are sections, my dear friend. So if as an NRI, you earn following kind of income in India and your TDS is duly applied, and assuming that you have no other income in India, then in that case, again, it is not mandatory for you to file the return of income in India at all. Let me also put up two exempt incomes which may be there in the hands of an NRI in India. As an NRI, if you have only NRE account interest in India, and as an NRI, you have only agriculture income in India. My dear friends, both of these income, may it be NRE account interest or may it be agriculture income interest, both of these income are specifically exempt under the provisions of income tax law. So if as an NRE, as an NRI, you have only these two income in India and no other income, then in that case, filing of the return of income is not mandatory at all for you. So these income, if they are in the hands of NRI, then in that case, no ITR filing is mandatory for such NRI for the relevant assessment year. At the end, I hope, my dear friends, this topic that whether it is mandatory for NRI to file ITR in India is a prevalent topic in terms of NRI earning outside India, and since they have emotional attachment to India, they have relatives in India, they already have some investment in India before they left India, or even when they earn outside India, they keep on investing in India. A very big important question for them is to know whether it is mandatory for them to file ITR or not. I hope this video will be fruitful to them. It will serve them in terms of understanding their liability of filing return in India. In case of any query, you may ask me. Thank you very much. Jai Hind.